Hey, I want to thank you guys for the goggles I picked up over at ESPN Technologies.
Oh, Kev, that's so nice. Thank you for going there.
Everyone who is going hard for their clinched goggles, it's these two
that have made it happen. Yes, we work hard to make sure you guys get these goggles.
How many have you guys made so far?
768 goggles around there, estimation.
Congrats, gang.
What are you going to be doing Saturday before the game? How are you going to whittle away your hours before? I mean, we know you're on the air.
I was going to say, I'm going to be sleeping. I have to do 6 a.m. to 9 a.m., so I'm going to come home and take a nap. And then I'll get up, watch the game, and do the post-game show. So I'd love to rage and drink and do all that, but I can't, man. I'm working.
I can dig it.
Goldstein's going to be sleeping away. Yeah.
How will you be spending your time Saturday?
My friend invited me over, and I'm thinking about it, but last playoff game during COVID, I watched by myself, and I just feel like that's maybe what I should do. You know what I mean? Just keep the streak alive.
Make it personal.
Yeah.
Hold up. Did you watch the Kansas City game by yourself?
No.
Oh, okay. So, yeah, you got to watch. You got to watch them all
alone.
That's
what I'm saying. I got to watch alone. Can't watch the, you know, don't watch alone. Not here. We're watching alone.
I got to pick up the slack for Goldstein. I'm going to rage. Flack attack, baby, because that's what's happening tomorrow. Browns, look, playoffs are back, and I am hyped up about it. I don't think I'm going to sleep until the game starts. I'm gonna be on air for basically that entire time. But the Browns are going into Houston and getting the dub 27-17. Let's ride!
Here we go, Brownies. Here we go. Hoo, hoo. Guys, it's playoff time. I'm getting that fever. You got that fever? Flacco fever, baby. Can't wait for it. The offense is going to tear up. The defense should tear up. CJ Stroud, excellent quarterback. No doubt about that. Probably a top five rookie season of all time. The guy's fantastic. And we didn't face him the first time around. Doesn't matter. Jim Schwartz and that defense is going to be prepared for him. Myles Garrett is going to eat that offensive line up. No doubt about that. And then, obviously, on the offensive end, Amari Cooper. Only had, 260-plus yards last time that we faced them. Too easy. It's too easy, folks. Give me the Browns 31-24. Here we go, Brownies. Here we go. Hoo, hoo.
We need a prediction from you.
Oh, yeah, prediction. Whew, I thought you were coming in for something else. That's an easy one. I love the Browns in this game. Give me the Browns 34, Texans 21.
Prediction. It's going to be a lot of fun. I can't wait. I'm starting to get anxious. Not nervous. Anxious because we've been building this game up for 2 weeks. But I think the Browns go back into Houston like they did a couple weeks ago. I think they score a lot of points. They don't give up a lot of points. The Browns win this one 30-21, and the Browns are advancing to the divisional round of the playoffs.
All right, here's what I want to happen. I want Houston to win the coin toss. I want them to defer. And I want the Browns to go right down the field like they did on December 24th, take a 7-0 lead, and then unleash the dogs on C.J. Stroud. I like the Browns to win 31-17.
All right, here we are. We're on the patio at Stats in Houston. You can see the Rockets logos. But I guess I got to predict the game. And I think the game is going to be right on the line. I think... You know, a lot of Browns fans are predicting a blowout. You know, you're not facing Case Keenum coming up in this game. I think Stroud will play pretty well. I think the Browns will make some mistakes and turn it over, but I think the Browns will have enough in the end. Get ready. I think it's going to be a heart attack. I got the Browns. 31-28.
We need your prediction, Riz.
First of all, folks, did you see what that is?
That's the sun. I haven't seen it in about 3 weeks. My prediction is this, and this isn't just homerism stuff. The Browns should win this game.
They're the better team. I know strange things happen in the playoffs, especially wild card weekend, super wild card weekend. But I like the Browns' defense. I like the Browns' quarterback play at the moment. I think Flacco's on fire. I think other than maybe Josh Allen, who's really hot, man, Joe Flacco's ready to go. I look for the Browns who put up 30. I think the Texans will hang around. CJ's a good player, and we didn't see him last time around. I picked the Browns to win by 10. I'll say 30-20, Browns over the Texans. Now, I don't want to get ahead of myself. boy, if the Browns win this playoff game, next week will be on fire.
There's another thing that we could discuss that I just learned about. David's on a third date.
Yes. Yes. Dirty laundry air. Yes.
And he's wondering how this third date should be spent. Your idea was going to a restaurant.
No, my idea was Dave and Buster's. I have a ton of Dave and Buster's gift cards, so I was going to really splurge and go all out. So that was an idea. Bowling, I think, is a good idea. I love bowling.
Question. Really the question is, how do you feel if you're going on a date and the guy that you're out with uses gift cards?
That's what I'm worried about.
I could see it both ways. I could see somebody going, wow, he's using gift cards, or somebody going, wow, he's smart, he's using gift cards. So I would tend to think about the latter. I mean, if a dude's going to save some money, that's not a bad thing.
You know, if Dave wants to use those Dave and Buster gift cards, I'll give him some Wendy's gift cards also to throw in. You swing by and get a little late night on your way home. There you go.
Yeah, baby, you want to help me win some tickets for the Nintendo Switch at Dave and Buster's?
I'm really digging on that new Super Mario, baby.
Want to be my Princess Peach for the night?
Ooh, that's a little low now.
I love it. I love it. I think you got some good things going on.
See, thank you.
All right, I feel confident.
Does she follow us? Is she going to see this?
I don't think so.
She's seen every episode of No Names, Please.
Please don't watch this, Madison.